Studying inductively is a learning process that takes time, and there are no hard and fast rules. You'll sometimes find observation, interpretation, and application happening simultaneously, and that's okay. Paul wrote in Romans 12:2, "And do not be conformed to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, so that you may approve what is the good and well-pleasing and perfect will of God." The last step in inductive Bible study, application, involves asking the question, "How do I respond?" It is the act of putting to use or into operation what God has been teaching you through observation and interpretation, with the goal of experiencing what Paul calls transformation, or simply, life change. In this video, we'll review the notes you've taken over this study that are stored in your saved John 7:1-39 Bible study notebook, and create the equivalent of a handwritten personal Bible journal that you can use with your studies in the future. It will help you think through how to apply what you've learned. With John 7:1-39 open in the Lexham English Bible in the right panel, click Tools, select Notes, click the Notebook icon, and then the plus button. Give this new notebook the name Journal. Then select the notebook by clicking it. We'll create a journal entry for our passage by clicking New Note. Click More Options and select Add Anchor from the drop-down. Add the reference, John 7:1-39, and click Add. This will keep all your journal notes about John 7:1-39 connected to the passage. Now you are ready to begin your journal. You can bold, italicize, or underline, just as you would in your word processor to help you best organize your journal. Now, close your Lexham English Bible by clicking the X at the top right of the panel. Open another instance of the Notes tool and find the notebook you created called John 7:1-39 Bible Study Notes. You will see all the notes you created earlier. Now you can easily reference what you have learned about the ABCs, your time spent observing the 5 W's and H, the insight you learned from looking at the Lexham Bible Dictionary, comparing Bible versions and cross-referencing, your word study findings, and your discoveries from various commentaries. To help you think through how you can apply what you've learned, we'll insert the following questions in the note in the journal. What does God want me to understand or think about this passage? What does God want me to believe? What does God want me to desire? And what does God want me to do? Once again, you can bold, italicize, or underline this information as you like. You can also attach information from a Logos resource to your notes. For this example, we'll bring up the Evangelical Commentary in the Bible in a separate panel. Click More Options and select Add Anchor from the drop-down. Highlight the text you want to attach. For this entry, we'll highlight the sentences, "Jesus' reluctance to return to Judea is understandable when we recall the events of his last visit. The subject of his death arose then, and it would arise again. In fact, this would be Jesus' last visit to Jerusalem, and in the coming spring, he would be crucified. Nevertheless, his brothers urge him to go, to make his identity plain, but their intentions are not in Jesus' interest since, as John states clearly, they did not believe in him." Ensure selected text is selected and click Add. Now the specific passage you've anchored will be readily available whenever you return to your journal. Or you can copy and paste text you want to be visible in your note by highlighting the section, hitting Command C to copy or Control C, and Command V to paste or Control V. Logos will even give you the citation. Logos will save your journal for easy access anytime you want to begin a new entry, which can be found by searching for the notebook in the Notes tool. You can use this first journal and the application questions as a template for future entries. What is God nudging you to do with what you've learned from your study in John? Spend some time in prayer, and then answer the suggested application questions in your journal. The ABCs, observation, interpretation, and application steps of inductive Bible study are easy with Logos. To learn how to use more features within Logos, consider starting the Logos 8 Sermon and Bible Lesson Prep Series and Academic Series.